above us all, Shepherd of us all,
Savior of us all, Lover of us all.
We are on the Lord's side. We will never give up. We are overcomers. For the Lord God is on our side. We are on the Lord's side. We will never give up. We
Father, Immortal Holy Ghost, Lord, we give you glory, we give you honor, we give you adoration for whom you are, Daddy, for the privilege and opportunity we have again, once again, to be in your presence. Lord, we adore you, magnify your holy and mighty name. We give you glory and honor. Ancient of Days, as I've come before you by your grace, Daddy, Lord, we have come to renew our strength in you. We have come to receive from you. We have come for you to teach us, my Lord, my Father, through your word, how best to serve you, how best to be your disciple here. Lord, through your word this morning, Ancient of Days, Father, Lord, let your word begin to illuminate our life in the mighty name of Jesus. Abba, Father, I have no power of my own, I have no wisdom of my own. But the Lord, I ask you to come and take absolute control. Come and do that which you only will do in the life of your children this morning. And let your name and name alone be glorified and magnified. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
Child of God, this morning, by the mercy and the grace of God, a small word of exhortation before we pray is titled The Power in the Blood. The Power that in the blood. Which blood? Not the blood of goats, not the blood of lamb, but the blood of Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord, somebody.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The power that is in the blood. In the book of 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 18 to 19. He said expressly there, 1 Peter 1:18-19. He said, knowing that you were ransomed from your futile ways, inherited from your forefathers, not with perishable things, such as silver or gold, 19, but with the precious blood of Christ, like that of a lamb without blemish or spot. This morning, the Bible is awakening me and you for us to realize that a price was paid on our heads. And that price that was paid is not the price of the quality or quantity of gold or silver. But the Bible is talking entirely here that the price that was paid on my head and on your head is a price of a precious, blameless blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. And that is why each time any true Christian, when you realize a price paid on your head, on my head, we need to quickly reconcile ourselves to God. We do not let that blood to be in vain. You see, in the entire Bible, a lot of blood was mentioned. And it will strike us to understand that from Genesis to Revelation, there is no blood in the Bible that was called precious except the blood of Jesus Christ. It is also known as incorruptible. You see, the fact that sin affected the blood of man through Adam, because he is the first man that God created, For the fact that, you know, for the fact that sin affected his blood, that fact made the virgin birth of Jesus Christ necessary. So if Christ was to be son of Adam, he wouldn't have been a sinless man. Praise the Lord, somebody.
Hallelujah.
He did not have a drop of Adam's blood in his veins. Because he did not have what? A human father. The seed of man did not get Mary. No? That's the mother of Jesus Christ. The seed of man did not get Mary to be fertilized for Christ to be born. His body was of Mary, but his blood was of Holy Ghost. Jesus' body did not decompose after 3 days. I want somebody to understand me. His body did not decompose after 3 days, but the body of Lazarus did decompose. Amen.
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 The death of Jesus Christ never did, he never decomposed.
Amen.
That's what the Bible is trying to tell us there. That a big difference. But the body of Lazarus, the Bible says after 4 days, is almost decomposing. That was why when Jesus Christ came to where he was buried, the sisters, they were not willing, you know, to exhume him. Why? Because they know he might be smelling. But when Jesus Christ, after 3 days, he came back, his body never did what? He never decomposed. Why? Book of Hebrews chapter 9 verse 12 says something there again. He said, he entered once for all into the holy places, not by the means of the blood of goats and calves, but by means of his own blood, thus securing an eternal redemption. Now, 13, for if the blood of goats and bulls and the sprinkling of the five persons with the ashes of a heifer sanctify for the purification of the flesh, how much more with the blood of Christ, who through eternal spirit offered himself without blemish to God, purify our conscience from dead works to serve the living God. Praise the Lord. Man can only be cleansed when we anchor ourselves to that blood. That is why that blood is so precious. That blood never allow anything sin to come around. If we were to allow the blood of Jesus Christ to work for me and you, it is a single word that the devil never wants to hear from the mouth of a child of God. The blood of Jesus Christ is efficacious. He's the only one who can purify. He's the only one who can sanctify us from the dead works, from our sinful ways. He's the only one who can do that. So every drop of the blood that flowed in his body is still in existence. And is still as fresh as it was when it flowed from his wounds. So the blood of Jesus is one of the most powerful weapons that we can use in prayer. When we plead the blood in prayer, because it speaks for me and you, that blood speaks for me and you. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 24. Hebrews 12, 24. It says something there. He said, and to Jesus, the mediator of a new covenant, and to the sprinkled blood that speaks a better word than the blood of Abel. The blood of man seeks for vengeance. That is why we normally say, we that come from Africa, our great-great-grandfathers, they must have done things that we do not know about. Many of them killed, you know, because of power, because of wealth. That blood speaks, it still speaks what? Vengeance. But the Bible is saying that the blood of Jesus Christ is what is a mediator of a new covenant.
Amen.
And to the sprinkled blood that does what? It speaks better things for me and you. So the earlier we realize how to call on that blood for total cleansing from dead works, the moment we realize the efficacy of that blood to liberate us from every ancestral curse, from every generational curse. The only thing that can do that is that blood, is the blood of Jesus Christ. It's the blood of Jesus Christ. The blood of Jesus Christ speaks life and forgiveness, while Abel's blood does what? It cries for vengeance. So whenever the blood is applied or pleaded by faith, whenever that blood is pleaded in righteousness, in holiness, no matter how, it does not matter how long that situation has been, whenever that blood is being pleaded in righteousness, in holiness, in faith, Satan cannot touch you. That situation can never stand as it was. When it is being what? When it's being pleaded in cleanness of hand, in total submission, and in faith, that situation to which it is applied must surely do what? It must surely surrender. He cannot, he has no ability, he has no power to do what? He was not able to pass the blood of Jesus Christ. No. The blood of Jesus Christ is the end matter. Revelation chapter 12, verse 11. He said, and they have conquered him by the blood of what? The blood of what? Of the Lamb. And by what? And by the testimony of their mouth. For they loved not their lives unto death. So we overcome by what? By the precious blood, by the application of that blood. So as a believer in Jesus Christ, as a true believer, let me use that word, because everybody in Christ says, I'm a believer. But every true believer, every true committed believer, our protection, our hiding place is under that blood. It is the faith in the blood that gives me and you victory over the devil and over problem. It is belief that we have in that blood. That is what works for me and you as a true believer. Let's go back again to Hebrews 10. Hebrews chapter 10. From 1 to 4. Hebrews 10, 1 to 4. He said, for since the law has but a shadow of the good things to come, instead of the true form of these realities, it can never, by the same sacrifices that are continually offered every year, make a perfect those who draw near to. Otherwise, would they not have ceased to be offered, since the worshippers, having once been cleansed, would no longer have any consciousness of sins? He's asking the question there. Verse 3. But in these sacrifices, there is a reminder of sins every year. Now 4. For it is impossible for the blood of bulls and goats to take away sins. You see, that is why people, a lot of people do today. What is why given churches? They say, go and bring this, go and bring this bull. We use it to sacrifice. You are free. Now, the only one that can do that total sanctification, when it is being applied in faith, is the blood of what? Is the blood of Jesus Christ. Is the blood of Jesus Christ. Blood of Jesus Christ, efficacious. It's not the blood of man. It's not the blood of God. Today, many believers, we do not realize what we have. I listened to a testimony of somebody. He said that only if Christians can know whom they are, what we are carrying. If devil sees a true child of God, because that blood runs in you, he cannot have that confidence. He cannot have what it takes to come near you, to come near me, if we realize. But many times, we answer that name, but we don't know what is in us. If we know the blood we are carrying, we will be running away from anything that is defilement. Because that blood is pure. That blood does not want anything contamination. It does not want anything pollution. That is why sin is an abomination before him. Something that is sinless. Something that is incorruptible. So that is why when we say we are Christians and we are still living in defilement, we are still living in sins, we are defiling that precious blood. And we cannot continue to live in sin
and say we apply the blood. No. But when the blood is being applied in the sanctification and purification of mind, in holiness and righteousness, you know that there is no situation. That situation have not been had or seen that cannot bow to that blood. No matter how strong they say that that Juju man is, he can never stand the blood of Jesus Christ. So as a child of God, we need to know who we are. The only thing that can make that blood seem as if it's not working is when there is sin, when there is contamination around us. When there is sins. But thank God for the great privilege that he has for me and you. What a privilege for us to be his presence again by this hour. It's an opportunity. Praise the Lord, somebody. I don't know.
Hallelujah.
Somebody will say maybe tomorrow. Procrastination is very, very dangerous because nobody can be able to know what's going to happen in the next second. I don't know in many ways that we have defied that precious blood that is flowing in me and you that made us to answer Christ-like. In any way that we have defied that blood, in any way that we have contaminated that blood, in any way that we have allowed that blood. You see, there is what is called the people that did geography. They said, conference town. You know, when two rivers, what we seem to other, not to understand, see, rivers don't flow together like that. There must be, you see, when River Nile and River Benue is coming, they don't just flow into other. If you study geography very well, there is always a separation. Before this one can enter, this one and this one enter, there is something in between. If ordinary creation can be able to know that, no, this one does not belong to me. That is why they call it a confluence. A confluence is where two rivers, you know, try to meet together. This one is saying, no, if others can know that, no, this one is not for me, this one is not for me. In other ways, we as Christians, we should realize that we are carrying a precious blood. That any other contaminated blood is not supposed to come near through sin. This morning, thank God the book of 1 John is there for us. I want us to pray. 1 John 1:9. Say, but if we confess our sins, the Lord Almighty, if we confess, not out of ordinary mouth, but if we realize today, oh, so this precious blood is with which I am being paid for. And I am doing anything I like. No, enough is enough. See, if we confess our sins faithfully, say God is faithful and just to do what? To forgive us our sins. And to do what? And to cleanse us from every unrighteousness so that the blood of Jesus Christ will begin to work for me and you. I want us to pray this morning. I want us to ask God. Because the Bible says, if we say we are not sinners, there is no truth in us. If we want that blood to work in maximum for me and you, I want us to sincerely go before him this morning as we have come before him in this mountain this hour and to say, oh Lord, in every area that I have allowed sin to dominate my life, I have to contaminate that precious blood of yours that you shed on the cross for me. Lord, this morning I cry unto you, Lord, have mercy. In the name of Jesus, let us open our mouth and begin to ask God. Open our mouth to pray and ask God. Father, in the name of Jesus, my Lord and my Father, Eternal of Ages, in any area, my Lord and my God, oh Lord Jesus, that my Lord my God, to dominate my life in every area, Lord Jesus, not to contaminate me, my Lord and my Father, I do this mercy. I have blessed. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Mighty name. We have prayed. I want us to pray again. He said in the book of Romans 8. He asked us a question there, but we're going to answer that question upon this mountain this morning. When Apostle Paul was writing to the book of to the people of Romans, he asked in Romans chapter 8, from verse 38 to 39, he said, who shall separate us from the love of Christ? There is something that can separate you if you are not careful. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Who
shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution of famine or nakedness or danger or sword? Who can separate us? One of the major things that can separate us from the love of Christ is sin. It's unholy life. If sin is not there, that is when the blood begins to come near. Don't forget that in this world, Bible did not tell me and you that we should not that the tribulation will not come, that trial will not come. But he said, be of good cheer, I have conquered. The Bible, it begins to come nearer to help me and you. First of all, when the passage is clear, which means there is nothing hindrance as per sin. But if sin is there, if sin is there, already we are separated. Already that person is what is living, but is dead. Is that it's like a walking corpse. You can answer a Christian by mouth, but in reality, God is far from that one. Like our apostle normally tell us, he said, many people that we call great men of God, without knowing that God have left them. When Saul was dethroned in the realm of the spirit, he still acted as a king in the land of Israel. Am I communicating this morning?
Yes, sir.
But already, sin have separated him, sin of what? Disobedience. We're going to pray this morning. Say, oh Lord, any sin that wants to separate me, my Lord, my Father, from you, Father, Lord, I denounce them this morning in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the Holy Ghost. Intergenerational ancestral. Oh, my Lord, my Father. In the name of Jesus. I denounce them in the name of Jesus.
By the blood of
Jesus, my name, we are praying.
Amen.
Our time is fast spent. I just occurred to me this morning. Let us pray this one before we take one or two prayers more, as time may permit us. I want us to pray, because I don't want us to open our mouth and pray and our hearts will not be heard, that heaven will not hear us this morning. I want us to remember what the book of Micah said in that Micah chapter 6, verse 1. He said, hear what the Lord says. Arise. Lead their case before the mountain and let the hill hear your voice. You see, this morning we are pleading our case. I am pleading my case. I don't know about you. I'm pleading my case. Say, Obia, arise, lead your case. In any area that you know that you have allowed yourself to be defiled, therefore that blood not working in you. Say, oh Lord, as I come to this mountain this morning, as I plead my case before you, Lord, let your attentive ear hear me. Do not pass me by. Wipe away, my Lord, my Father, my transgressions. In the name of Jesus. Will be a man of God this
morning.
Oh my God.
Father,
my
God.
You know where I'm
Romans 12:1-2. He said, I appeal to you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, to present your bodies as what? As a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God. Why? Because that is our spiritual worship. It is what is required of any child of God. Can you present to God a body that is defiled? Can you present to God a body that is contaminated? We are going to ask God this morning. Say, oh Lord, my Lord, my Father, let your precious blood, let it cleanse me from every works of unrighteousness, from every dead works. Father, Lord, cleanse me this morning by your precious blood. In the name of Jesus, we be about this hour.
Let your blood,
It's in the verse 2 of that very chapter. He said, do not be conformed to the pattern of this world.
Please, but be ye every thought so what?
Amen.
Can somebody hear me?
Yes. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
He said, do not be conformed to the pattern of this world, may be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that by testing you may discern what is will of God, what is good and acceptable. You see, conformity. Conformity is another word for compromise. It's another word to compromise. When we conform, we defy that blood that was spread before on your head, under my head. When we conform, we defy that blood. We're going to ask God. Say, Lord, every spirit of conformity, every spirit of compromise in my life, this morning, let the fire of Holy Spirit, let it destroy them in the name of Jesus. Hope you are not the child of God.
Just have a second.
30 seconds is enough. If you can do it with all our mind and our spirit, in genuineness of mind, I don't know. Maybe a prayer point that we raise because of time might not be that one, you know. You know yourself, I know myself. Go before God just in 30 seconds. Say, Lord, because of your blood, so thing that I did, even though no man sees me, no woman sees me, but I know you see me. But because of your precious blood, Father, Lord, bless me. Father, Lord, forgive me. Just open your mouth, talk to him. He's the Lord. Every
language.
In the name of Jesus, we are praying.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, we thank you. Immortal Holy Ghost, we adore you. And we thank you, Jesus, for that incorruptible blood, for that sinless blood of yours, Daddy, that you use to pay that costly price on the cross of Calvary because of me. Who am I that are so mindful of me? Lord, in every area, Daddy, that I have traded on that blood foolishly, in every area, my Lord, my God, that I've used that blood and I've taken advantage of that blood, or my brother have taken advantage of that blood, Lord, have mercy. In the name of Jesus, Any contamination in me, Lord Jesus, by your precious blood. Any contamination in us, my Lord, my God. Father, I'm not cleansing in the mighty name of Jesus. Let your blood begin to work for us. Let your blood, my Lord, my Father. Let it, my Lord, my Father, stand for us. In the name of Jesus. Abba, Father, we just want to thank you this morning. We give you glory, we give you honor. Let your blood bring a pure sanctification and purification over every life upon this mountain. My Lord, my Father, we thank you. We give you glory, we give you honor. Blessed be your holy and mighty name. For in Jesus' most wonderful name, we are praying with thanksgiving.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Brethren, we have heard the word of God. We have seen what the blood of God of Christ does in life of his children, of the children of God. Brethren, let us embrace the blood of Christ with all holiness and righteousness. And I pray this message this morning, God will use it to purge us in any way we have been against him. The power in the blood. All we ever needed is in the blood.